In this video, we're finding the general solution of the separable differential equation dx dt is equal to x times the quantity x minus 1. And then we apply an initial condition, x of 0 equals 1/2, to find the particular solution of this equation corresponding to that initial condition. So we're going to start by separating variables here. And that means we want to get all the x dependents on one side. So on the left, we have dx over x minus 1, and then all the t dependents on the right side. So over there, it's just a dt. Next, we integrate both sides of this equation. And the integral on the right-hand side is really quick to do. The integral of dt is just t, and we're going to throw in our arbitrary constant plus c over on the right-hand side of this equation. But the left-hand side, we're going to use partial fractions decomposition to integrate this thing. So we want to break this integrand down into a sum of individual fractions that each have only one of these factors in their denominators. So we make a partial fractions decomposition proposal. And we propose that this problematic fraction can be broken down into a over x plus a b over x minus 1. And to nail down what a and b are, we just clear all the denominators real quick, meaning we multiply both sides by the least common denominator, that's x times x minus 1. And when we simplify the left-hand side, that's just 1. On the right-hand side, when we distribute these factors to the a-containing term, the x's cancel, leaving us with an a times the quantity x minus 1. And then in the b-containing term, the x minus 1 cancels, leaving us with b times x. Now this is really quick to solve using substitution. If we let x equal 1, that means the a-containing term vanishes, and I end up with b times 1, or just b, on the right-hand side. On the left-hand side, there's a 1, so we just found out b is equal to 1. Okay, then we sub in x equals 0 and see what happens. So subbing in x equals 0, the b-containing term vanishes, and I end up with a times negative 1 is equal to 1, which means a is negative 1. So now for this integral on the left-hand side, we found out it can be represented as a over x, that's negative 1 over x, plus b over x minus 1, but that's 1 over x minus 1 dx. And on the right-hand side, we have t plus an arbitrary constant c. So now we can integrate each term of this integral on the left-hand side. And the first term gives us the negative of the natural log of the absolute value of x. The second term, natural log absolute value x minus 1. And on the right-hand side, the spectator at this point, t plus c. So our next goal is to solve for x explicitly as a function of t. And to get this done, we need to combine our logs into a single logarithmic expression. So this is natural log absolute value x minus 1 over x. And there we're just using the log property that the log of a difference is the same as the quotient of the logs. And the first term here was the one being subtracted. And on the right-hand side, again, a t plus c. So at this point, we can exponentiate, and we end up with the absolute value of x minus 1 over x is equal to e to the t plus c. And there's a really common trick at this point. E to the t plus c is the same as e to the c, e to the t, and remember c is some arbitrary constant. So c can take on any real value, but e to the c is always going to be a positive number. We can go ahead and just say, well, e to the c is still an arbitrary constant, and I can just give that the name c, just understanding there it's not the same c I had in the exponent, but it is an arbitrary constant. So I can write this as c e to the t with a little side note that c must be bigger than 0 because this exponential only takes on positive values. All right, so now it's time to deal with the absolute value part. And if x minus 1 over x happens to be positive, the absolute value does nothing. If x minus 1 over x is negative, the absolute value multiplies by negative 1. And this means I have two possible solutions here, either positive or negative on the right-hand side, c e to the t, where c must be a positive number. Well, we can make this a lot simpler by just saying the result is c e to the t, where c can be positive or negative. So I'll just say c just has to be some number belonging to the set of real numbers. All right, so we're left with x minus 1 over x is equal to c e to the t, where c can be anything, and I still want to solve for x as a function of time explicitly. So what we're going to do here is multiply both sides by x, and then gather all the x-containing terms on one side of the equation. So I end up with x minus 1 equals x times c e to the t, and then I subtract this term, x times c e to the t, and I add 1 to both sides, and this gives me x minus x c e to the t is equal to 1. Factoring out the x, I get x times 1 minus c e to the t is equal to 1. And finally, I arrive at my general solution of the differential equation, x as a function of time. So I'm just going to highlight that by saying parentheses t. So x of t is 1 over 1 minus c e to the t. So this is the general solution of our first order differential equation. And as always, we see one arbitrary constant in that solution. So if we start subbing in a bunch of different values of c, it's going to create a family of curves, this set of infinitely many curves that satisfy the original differential equation. And this is what the family of curves looks like. So that's just a bunch of different c values. I think I put in 50 different c values. And we see all these different functions that satisfy the original differential equation. Our next goal is to specify the curve that satisfies the differential equation, but also passes through the point 0, 1 half. This is what the initial condition is about. So we want to satisfy the condition that x of 0 is equal to 1 half. So all we have to do is plug in 1 half for the x value, and then plug in 0 for the t value, and then we'll solve for c and nail down the particular solution. Well, e to the 0 is just 1, so I don't have to worry about that piece. And then solving this for c, I can see on the left side I have 1 over 2, on the right side 1 over 1 minus c, and that means 1 minus c must be 2. In adding c to both sides and subtracting the 2, I end up with c equals negative 1. So now we take that value of c and plug it back into the general solution, and I'm going to go ahead and subscript this as a particular solution. So I'm going to write it as xp of t, and that's 1 over 1 plus e to the t. So I want to finish by just pointing out what's happening graphically when we apply the initial condition. We started with a family of curves given by this form 1 over 1 minus c e to the t. We specified an initial condition, insisting that the curve we're interested in must pass through the point 0, 1 half. So we're selecting a single curve from this infinite family that happens to pass through that point 0, 1 half. And now we have the special curve that both solves this original differential equation, dx dt equals x times x minus 1, and passes through the point 0, 1 half. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab. And best of luck on your math and physics journey.